Hello everyone, my name is Nathan, and today it's time for another episode of Oxygen Not Included Spaced Out the DLC. In the previous episode, we have made this water cleaning system, and it is definitely doing its job. The only change that I've made is I made the water go into the left side of the pool, because we are pumping it out on the right side, and therefore the pool is being cleaned up from the left to the right. If we check out the germs, we can confirm this. There are 42,000 or so germs on the left side, and there are, 196,000 for instance right here. So slowly but surely this water is going to be recycled and therefore cleaned up. In the meantime, I'm still doing all of the research. I just want to knock this out of the park. There's actually not much more to go. And in today's episode, I want to experiment around with arbor trees. Now, in the previous episode, we've established that there were new updates on the game. Currently, we don't have access to everything in the save game. I'm glad that the majority of you would actually be willing to go along with a restart. However, we are gonna wait a week or so until the next update is out. This way, we can hopefully ensure we don't have to restart it right away again. However, in between the episodes, I've been playing around with a couple of things, and I actually have a really, really great idea for a new base. So I'm almost 100% sure you are not going to regret a restart. It's not going to be like this series where I still had to figure out a few things and have a totally different plan for my approach and also the layout of the base. It's going to be like 100 times better, let me tell you. Well, maybe let's say 7.5 times better. Anyways, arbor trees are actually a different thing for me. I've never tested things out with them. In the previous series, we built some of them, but we never really ended up harvesting them. One thing I do know about the arbor trees is we want to supply them with hydroponic farms, and they're gonna require 3 tiles in space. So we have to space them out like this, for instance. Now, what we're gonna be doing today is kind of figure out a bunch of ratios and what we can actually do with the arbor trees. What possibilities we have to make them useful to us. Now, I think eventually I would like to end up with about 6 of those trees. We will have to supply them with polluted water, which we will be getting from petroleum generators that are actually capable of using the ethanol we can get from the logs that we get from the trees. Currently, we only have 3 arbor acorns. I do not want to waste them right here because they do require some fertilization. If we check this out, they actually take 10 kilograms of dirt per cycle. And as long as we are not supplying the polluted water, it's just going to be a waste of dirt. Next up, let's have a look at the refinement. We would want to dive into the ethanol distillers, which take 1 kilogram of lumber per second, so 600 kilograms per cycle. And it looks as though from the arbor trees we get 300 kilograms per cycle. So 2 arbor trees should do for 1 distiller, theoretically. I'm not gonna think this perfectly through. We just want to get a basic idea of what we could accomplish with this. So if we have the trees at full efficiency, we should be able to run 6 of these distillers. We do not necessarily need to run this at full efficiency. So I think for now I'm just gonna go with 4 distillers and we go from there. Another thing we might want to do is actually close this off. Oh, thinking about this, we might need a little bit more space. So if I move these out 1 more block each, then I can also run a ladder setup without disturbing the right and left ones. That means I can have a ladder running down the right and left side right there. And we also move in these distillers. Something like that should be working out. And then we can go ahead and enclose this entire contraption. I'm not sure what else we need, but we certainly need other things in order to make this work, especially the petroleum generators, for instance. And I would imagine we also need to run a cooling loop. Actually, that's not gonna work either because the ladder is in the way of the tree still. So let's just leave that be. And we're gonna maintain 2 fewer trees. Since we're only running 4 distillers, it's not even that bad. Checking out the distillers, they are producing 500 grams of ethanol, some polluted dirt and carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide, is this actually, let me see. Yeah, that's a liquid exit, so we can take the ethanol, and then I'm presuming the carbon dioxide is going to be expelled into the air. The polluted dirt we should be able to either feed to our pokeshells, which we have plenty of by now, or alternatively we could use a compost and put it back into the trees as a fertilizer. So 333 grams per second. What can we do with the compost? Let's check that out. We can process 100 grams per second, also producing some heat. We're gonna need 10 kilograms per arbor tree per cycle, which means with 10 trees we need 100 kilograms per cycle. So that means we can process 1 kilogram of polluted dirt into normal dirt with a compost per 10 seconds. One cycle has 600 seconds, so 600 divided by 10 we will end up with 60 kilograms of processed polluted dirt per cycle. We would be producing around 200 kilograms of polluted dirt with our ethanol distillers. That means 60, 120, 180. We need at least 4 composts to take care of all the polluted dirt. But I think I'm just gonna go with 3 composts, so the excess polluted dirt we can use for our pokeshells. We're gonna then keep on closing this off. Now we have a little bit of space for the power stuff. We should be using a petroleum generator. That is gonna be using 2 kilograms of ethanol per second, giving us even more carbon dioxide and then polluted water back that we can use to hopefully feed the trees again. Now, how much do the trees actually require? 70 kilograms per cycle. That's not too much. 70 kilograms multiply by 10, 700 kilograms per cycle. We are producing 750 grams per second times 600. Well, that would be if we have them running all the time, which is not going to be the case, is it? Well, maybe we just keep them running. What does it matter at this point? One petroleum generator would be producing 450 kilograms of polluted water per cycle. This theoretically means if we run 2 of them, we should be fine, like so. This is at least in order to provide enough polluted water. They take 2,000 grams of combustible liquid, which is not something we are currently producing, no. We would need double the amount of ethanol distillers in order to get these generators running full time. But yeah, that is actually one thing I want to do for the next series. I want to have the perfect ratios. I want to make really nice and gigantic contraptions in order to take care of every aspect of the game. But for now, this doesn't need to be perfect. I just want to understand the ins and outs, the mechanics a little bit of the cycle. So 2 petroleum generators are gonna do it, even though they're not gonna be running all the time. Now, one more thing we might want to take care of is the carbon dioxide. We're producing around 166 grams with the ethanol distillers, and then there's also the 500 grams for each of the petroleum generators. That will be around 1,600 or so grams. Let's just round it up to 1,700 grams. And then we would probably need a carbon skimmer in order to get rid of that. I cannot use more carbon dioxide than I already have. The carbon skimmer can get rid of 300 grams per second, which means we would need about 7 of those. Holy cow. That is a lot of carbon skimmers and power. However, at this point, we don't have to worry about the power. There is unlimited power waiting in form of magma for us. So let's see how many we can get in here. That would be... Actually, we can get more than enough in there. So this is actually already 7, but I think I'm just gonna put in the 8. Or actually, hold on, I'm also gonna need a water sieve to take care of that. We're producing 1,000 grams of water with each carbon skimmer, and then we need to run it through a water... Wow, okay, this cycle actually takes a bit more than I first anticipated. But we need to run it through water sieves, which then is also gonna consume our sand, which is bad. We can take 5 kilograms, actually, of polluted water, so only with 2 water sieves we will be able to take care of 10 kilograms, no problem. This means I'm gonna skip the 2 carbon skimmers on the side, put a water sieve there. We now have 4 carbon skimmers, that would be 5 and 6, and then we have 1 too few. But let's see if that is going to matter in the end. It might actually not even be that bad since we have our cleaning system right here that is taking care of carbon dioxide that is overflowing. However, that probably means we want to leave some space open here. We'll see how that goes. Actually, we don't even need to leave this open because the extra carbon dioxide is just gonna overflow here and then it's gonna drop down again, which is good. I want this room to be filled up with carbon dioxide since that is what we are gonna produce anyways. One more thing I'm curious about, 15 degrees to 40 degrees. At the moment we are at 39 or so degrees, which is a little bit too much, but we're gonna solve that with the cooling loop. Okay, I can actually see this coming along, but we need to do more thinking about it. Let's maybe put in the water sieves now. And we're also gonna need our heavy watt joint plates here on the sides, which means I have to take apart the power cable just for a brief moment. Put the joint plates in its place. Actually, we don't even have this hooked up just yet, so I don't even have to hurry about this. But there we go. Water sieve goes here, and another one right there. Have it nice and symmetrically set up. I guess to get the perfect ratios, we would have to go much bigger, actually, because otherwise it's never gonna add up, mathematically speaking. Wonderful. Camille is just building the last petroleum generator. Then we have everything in place, and we should be able to do the plumbing. Let's think about that. Oof, this oil pipe is not convenient at all. Yeah, I'm gonna have to reroute this through the bottom here. Can I actually do that? Maybe I wanna go even one more down, so this is definitely not in the way. This is gonna go up there now. We might wanna go ahead and use up a little bit of the plastic so I can get rid of the excess oil I currently have. One good way to do that would be to use plastic ladders. This is a faster means of transportation anyways. So we're gonna exchange a whole bunch of these ladders with plastic ladders. Let's do the carbon skimmer loop first. This can actually be a closed loop. We only have to provide it with either polluted water or normal water, fill it up once, and then it should be running continuously, getting rid of the carbon dioxide, creating polluted water, and then we recycle the water again. So clean water from the water sieve is gonna provide these two carbon skimmers with fresh water, and we also need to do the same thing with the top one. Oh, this is gonna be a little bit of a challenge with the plumbing. Gonna do the same thing here on the other side. Let's try to keep it as symmetrical as possible. Can I actually rotate these guys? Oh yes, that's possible. So we're gonna switch this guy here around, and therefore we can run the plumbing into this tile. This means we can come out from here, bridge over there, and lead this into the water sieve. The same thing is gonna happen right here. We go out, over, bridge over, and lead it into here. This is absolutely wonderful. So bridge and another bridge like so. Gonna do the same thing on the other side. Here is gonna be the output. We then bridge over there and go into here. We go out there, bridge over here into there. Hold the phone. Somebody still needs to take apart the carbon skimmer here. Can you please do that? And now I can put it in this way. And we can also set up this bridge. And this should already be it for the carbon skimmers and the water sieves. Then maybe another thing we can already do is power up these. I also want to connect the petroleum generators. Now I'm basically waiting for this oil to be used up. This is still gonna take a while. So I'm taking this pipe apart and then I'm just gonna empty this. So all of this can be emptied. I already have a place to store it in. Actually, we don't need to do it right there. Ruby here is actually doing a phenomenal job. It has to be said, she's never stood out in a negative way. Unlike Jean the dummy, for instance. Great, now that we have this out of the way, all we want to do is join up these guys here. Now let me think. Yeah, I might want to do it this way. The problem with the outputs is always you don't want to go straight through the outputs. Unless you're willing to set up a bridge bypass, because as we know, the outputs never have priority. So when there's already some liquid coming from a different source, the liquid in the next machine is gonna be clogged up. What we want to do with these, of course, is go down and fill up the petroleum generators with the ethanol. Now, one thing I totally forgot about, we are producing the polluted water with the petroleum generators. However, we need to collect the liquid somewhere and pump it up. If we check out the mini liquid pump, this is only gonna input 1,000 grams. Oh, actually that would be enough, right? Because we're producing 750 grams. So we could have these liquid pumps here on either side, but they're not gonna fit because of the joint plate. So I might want to move the joint plates up here. Get rid of this one and this one. And we also have to get rid of the two bottom ladders. That is actually possible, but we need to supply the water sieves. Technically, they should still be able to reach it from this ladder here. I think that's gonna be possible. So both of the bottom ladders are gonna disappear once I'm done building. So let's imagine we're gonna have our liquid pumps right here. That means I can start my plumbing and go all the way up to my arbor trees. I need to check back again. They are using 70 kilograms per cycle. That is not a lot per second. That might be something we want to calculate a little bit more carefully, because if we end up with too much water, that's going to be a problem. But for now, we can just lead this all the way up again and resupply the arbitraries. Apart from the ratios not being exactly perfect, this actually looks quite promising. Now let's for instance assume we are gonna end up with a little bit too much polluted water. I think I wanna drag this all the way over here, and then we go all the way up, and then maybe dump it somewhere over here into our pool. I cannot do that, I can do it here. Gonna need another liquid bridge like so. And this is hopefully only gonna get rid of the excess polluted water. Then we also have to initially fill up this loop, and I think I'm just gonna do it with the churmy water for the time being. Yeah, I mean, we have no choice. I'm not sure if this is gonna have some consequences. It might have. But I think to get things running, I just quickly wanna bridge over here. We're then gonna move over into a filter. Yeah, this is just gonna be temporary, so I can filter out some polluted water. The polluted water is gonna go down and everything else is gonna move back into the system. Oh, that's not convenient. Let me swap this around. There, now we input it right here. It goes back into the loop, being dumped back down if it is not polluted water. If it is polluted water, we're just gonna bring it down and fill up our loop. Well, I mean, it's technically not a loop. We just want to input it into our tree farm until we have the production from our petroleum generators. We also want to continue this and initially fill up our water sieves so it can go into the carbon skimmers right away. So we're going to do that for both of the water sieves. I will have to remember which pipes to remove afterwards. I thought about this for a little bit and I came up with a better idea. I remembered that we actually have access to a little bit of starting ethanol in the other world, so I already set up a system in order to be able to pump this stuff over. I interrupted the oil line for the time being. Ethanol would then come into this direction, move all the way up here, and for now supply my petroleum generators, which are then gonna produce the polluted water to supply my arbitraries. I still have the polluted water coming down here in order to fill up the water sieve and carbon skimmer loop, since that is an independent loop. So let's see whether or not we can fill this up. Should be no problem. And I'm just gonna wait until the pipes are clogging up, meaning all of our carbon skimmers are full. Then we should be able to remove the bridges again. Okay, that actually looks pretty full to me. I would say we can remove those bridges. And that theoretically means we can get rid of this water again. So I want you to just run upstairs for the time being so we can get rid of this filter. One more thing we need to take care of is the heat production. So I already prepared a little steam chamber. This is also more or less temporary. I just want to know whether or not this system is going to work remotely the way I think it will. So what we want is just a little bit of water here. And what I think I'm gonna do is just tile this out in order to get rid of the oxygen in there to make it a vacuum. There we go, said and done. That means we should be able to get rid of all the tiles again, and we have a vacuum in there. We should be able to set up the aqua tuner next. Definitely holding his breath there. Gonna set up the aqua tuner right here, and then we're gonna supply it with power like so. Gonna need an insulated pipe to get in there, and then one pipe to get out of there, and then we want this to go through the entirety of the building here, so we can keep everything nice and cool. Let's maybe first think about the steam power output. We can put this right there. Steam power water is then gonna drop into the center there, I would say. That means we can get out of the aqua tuner like so, bridge over and do something like that. Yeah, if we set up a bridge, that should theoretically work out. Igneous rock, please. We're then gonna move this upwards and then bridge over into the first floor that we want to cool down. So at this point, I wanna go up and then we're gonna choose some radiant pipes. Maybe that is not even necessary. Should we just go with granite? Though, at least a couple of radiant pipes would really be great. At the moment, everyone is building and not taking care of my refineries, right? Let's put these at priority 6 for the time being, so we get some more of that juicy refined metal. So I'm thinking not all the pipes have to be radiant. We're just gonna have them radiant wherever I leave a gap now. This also means we might want to combine these pipes like so and make them go up at this point. That maybe makes more sense. I could really use the space right now. Then at the end, we want to switch to insulated pipes again, go down to the next floor, swap to granite, except where there are trees and machineries. Do that, 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 and that. Then move over again using insulated pipes, going down to the next floor, and so on and so forth, until, well, I guess right here on the top, it's going to be problematic. Maybe we just do a little swirly cooling loop. Oh, actually, thinking about it, we don't need this portion anymore. Yeah, that is something I can completely drain. Let's maybe remove those two pipes, and then we're gonna drain the rest of these. One more thing we can already do is set up a thermo sensor for the aqua tuner with its respective automation wire. Okay, I think I got the cooling loop together. It goes out from the aqua tuner, going through here, then joining up with the next row, joining up with the next row, taking a little turn. And then here, the bottom two floors, I decided to split up the loop. So one goes to the right, trying to keep the petroleum room cool. The other one is gonna go down, trying to keep the water sieves and carbon skimmers cool. Then they join back up together here and go back into the aqua tuner. It's a bit messy, but it should at least work. I maybe should have kept the polluted water downstairs in order to fill up this loop. Yeah, that's gonna bother me. How is it looking with our germs, by the way? Oh yes, much fewer germs, but soon enough we need to introduce new water. I'm just gonna let these guys finish building everything and also fill up the loop with the aqua tuner, and then we can start the system and see if it works. Alrighty, back we are. We should now actually be ready. As promised, I filled up the cooling loop with polluted water. It is now evenly distributed and it's always gonna flow through the aqua tuner. I set this to 30 degrees plus, because if we check here with the arbor trees, they can take 15 degrees up to 40 degrees. So 30 minus 14 degrees with the aqua tuner should be a safe margin. Then I guess the only thing we still require is a couple of pumps here, but then we are done and we can get this going. I also made a little mistake here. Of course, this output pipe here should go to the output of the bridge as well. But yeah, let's see this happen. We have our pumps going over here to the sides. They should also have the power already. Unfortunately, Turner acted like an idiot and deconstructed the ladder from the bottom. So yeah, I'm not proud of him. It's not his best day. Can you try this again? Thank you. Okay. He made up for it. Our pumps are in place. Let's go ahead and enable the petroleum generators. I just have to connect this and we should see this going for it. Oh no, it's actually not going over to the other petroleum generator. That's bad. Why wouldn't you do that? It's perfectly reasonable. What if we also set up a bridge, like so? Of course, we will have to take apart that stuff again once we have the system running. But all I want to see for the time being is the hydroponic farms being filled up with at least 10 kilograms, I believe they can take. And then I guess we can also start planting the trees finally. We unfortunately don't have that many trees just yet. We are just gonna have to make the best out of it and hope for more seeds. This also means, by the way, we should be able to close this off, which we should do, so this can get converted into steam. We're actually almost done with our research. This is the very last thing that we need to research. No, there's actually another thing here. But apart from that, we are done, so we can get rid of our research equipment as well. Now, both of the generators are running, which is exactly what I wanted to see. We're also picking up the water, supplying it to the arbor trees, and the hydroponic farms already seem to be full, at least most of them, so the extra water is just going up. The first arbor tree has been planted. We're just missing a little bit of dirt to get this going. There it is, growing. Yeah, it's gonna take a while to get this going, that's for sure. So maybe one thing I wanna do is set up a liquid shutoff so I have a little bit of manual control over it before it really gets started. Want to have an automation wire and a signal switch there. I'm gonna turn this off immediately, and that means for now we're gonna save the polluted water, accumulate it a little bit. I mean, right now everything is dependent on the ethanol we're bringing in from outside. We might even be tempted to set up another liquid shutoff here. Ah, darn it. Just placed it in the wrong spot. So this goes right here, and then I want to lead my ethanol through there. And of course also have control over the flow of ethanol. So maybe we want to stop it at some point. We want to wait for the trees to grow and give us new seeds. before we just go ahead and waste all the ethanol. Wonderful, we have our pipes filled up, we're ready to just keep these trees on growing. We will of course have to observe it, but whenever we need new or more polluted water, I can open up the ethanol line, and whenever we have too much polluted water, I open up the polluted water line to get rid of it. But yeah, now it's just a matter of time until we have all of these trees growing and then hopefully producing more seeds and everything. It's gonna be absolutely glorious. Great stuff. I would say with that out of the way, we're gonna wrap it up for the time being. We will of course have to observe what this does in the next episode. And as I said, with the next update, we're probably gonna start a new world, and it's gonna be the best world I've ever made. I'm pretty sure of that. Gusman and Joshua are actually taking on dangerous jobs. Yeah, they get scolded every now and then, so I will have to send them to bed. But yeah guys, with that out of the way, thank you so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, have a great time, and see you in the next one. By the way, germs are almost gone. Have a good one, bye bye.